Welcome back, fellow scientists. It's Justin again. Whoa, Mia, looks like you're going on a long trip. Where are you off to? What? We're going to the International Space Station? You mean the spacecraft that orbits Earth with astronauts from around the world? Okay, this'll be a huge adventure. But why do you want to go to the ISS? Ah, that makes total sense. If you want to see what makes Earth truly unique, there's no better view than from space. Let's do it! But before we go, you might want to cut down on your luggage. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to describe at least three unique characteristics of Earth that make it habitable. Let's investigate! From the International Space Station, we get an amazing view of Earth. I can see the entire planet. I see blue oceans, swirling white clouds, and vast stretches of land. Earth is home to you and me, but what do you think makes it so special? Pause the video and record your prediction in your guided notes. Earth is the only planet we know of that supports living creatures. It's habitable, meaning it has everything needed for humans, animals, and plants to survive and thrive. Scientists, what do you think a planet needs to be habitable? Good thinking. Earth has three key characteristics that allow living things to thrive. Take a look out the window and see if we can observe any. What do you notice about the color of the Earth? What I noticed first was how blue it is. Earth is often called the blue planet, and now I see why. Over 70% of its surface is covered in water. Earth is the only planet in our solar system with liquid water on its surface. Water is essential for life as we know it. Can you think of a living thing that doesn't need any water? You can't. Every living thing, from tiny insects to enormous whales, needs water to survive. But we know not all water is the same. Some water is fresh water, like in lakes, rivers, and streams, and other water is salt water, like the oceans. Take another look out the window. Do you think most of Earth's water is fresh water or salt water? Most of it is salt water. In fact, 97% of Earth's water is in the ocean. While most of Earth's water is liquid and free-flowing, some of it is frozen. Can you guess where most of Earth's frozen water is? Yes, the North and South Poles have glaciers and ice caps. This is where a lot of frozen fresh water can be found. What's one big difference between places on Earth that have flowing water and frozen water? Temperature. That's another characteristic of Earth that makes it habitable. Imagine if Earth was hundreds of degrees colder than it is now. What would happen to the water? That's right, its water would all be frozen solid, just like the ice caps. And what if Earth was hundreds of degrees hotter? Yep, all the water would evaporate or turn into gas. Luckily, Earth is just the right temperature to keep flowing and frozen water in balance, making it habitable for plants, animals, and humans. But why is Earth able to maintain the perfect temperature? Earth's location in the solar system plays a big role in making it habitable. As the third planet from the sun, Earth sits at just the right distance from it, not too close and not too far. Since the sun is a huge hot star that provides light and heat, a planet's distance from it has a major impact on its temperature and the amount of sunlight it receives. That's why scientists call the region the Earth is located in the Goldilocks zone, because it's just right for life. Earth's perfect placement within this habitable zone allows for temperatures that support living things, making it the only planet in our solar system where life can thrive. Earth's temperature is usually around 59 degrees Fahrenheit, but it can be much hotter or colder depending on where you are. For example, the coldest place where people live is northeastern Siberia, where temperatures can drop to negative 90 degrees Fahrenheit. That's way colder than your freezer. And the hottest deserts, like the Lut Desert in Iran, can reach a scorching 150 degrees Fahrenheit, which is even hotter than a sauna. These are some of the most extreme temperatures on Earth. Yet, life is still possible in these places. If Earth were much closer or farther from the sun, temperatures would be so extreme that life as we know it couldn't survive at all. Even though some places are freezing cold and others are blazing hot, overall, Earth's temperature stays in a range that allows life to survive. Distance from the sun isn't the only factor that impacts Earth's temperatures, though. Earth has a protective layer of gases that surrounds the planet. Do you know what it's called? The atmosphere. That's the third characteristic of Earth that makes it habitable. Earth's atmosphere is something truly special. Without it, life as we know it wouldn't exist. Think of it like a giant invisible shield wrapped around Earth. First, it keeps us warm by trapping just the right amount of heat. Without it, our planet would be an icy wasteland at night and blazing hot during the day. But that's not all. Earth's atmosphere also protects us. It acts like a superhero's force field, blocking harmful rays from the sun. The kind that could give you a really bad sunburn. It even stops meteoroids before they reach the ground. Most of them burn up in the atmosphere, so we don't have to worry about space rocks crashing down on us. And perhaps the most important thing of all, it helps us breathe. Earth's atmosphere is filled with oxygen, the gas our bodies need to survive. In fact, no other planet we know of has breathable oxygen like Earth does. While Mia and I explore the rest of the ISS, let's review everything we've learned today. Earth has three unique characteristics that make it habitable. It has liquid water, and it's the only planet we know of that does. It has a livable temperature. It's not too hot or too cold. And the atmosphere keeps us warm, helps us breathe, and protects us from harmful sun rays and meteoroids. To learn more about planet Earth, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Mia, there's no air outside of the ISS, no water, and the temperature in space, literally hundreds of degrees below zero. You know what? Earth has all that stuff naturally. Oxygen, just there. Water, everywhere. Temperature, mostly manageable. Yeah, I think I'm ready to go back now. Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time. Hey, hey.